Good morning students, welcome back. In previous class we are discussed the concept of inheritance. Now we can just glance those inheritance concept in a few seconds. Let's see what is inheritance. Inheritance is a mechanism of deriving a new class from a existing class or a old class. It is a process of deriving a new class from a existing class. This is called inheritance. And in inheritance we are using two terms, that is subclass and a superclass. Superclass is nothing but a parent class. Subclass is nothing but a child class or a derived class. Superclasses are classes which inherits the properties to the another classes. And subclasses are the classes which are derived from the superclass. And in inheritance there are five types are there, but in our Java programming language we are using only three types of inheritance concept. In those are single inheritance, multi-level inheritance, hierarchical inheritance. We are not using a hybrid inheritance and a multiple inheritance in our Java programming language. We have discussed in previous class why we are not using a multiple inheritance and a hybrid inheritance in a Java. Now in today's class we can discuss abstraction concept in a Java programming language. How we are going to use a abstraction concept in our programming language and how we are going to use that concept in our programming, let us discuss. Java abstraction. Here in this first we have to discuss in a abstraction concept. We are discuss abstraction concept and a abstract class and a abstract method, and one more thing is concrete class. These four types we have to know. Those are abstract method, abstract class, and a concept of abstraction and a concept of concrete class. First, now we discuss what is abstraction. Abstraction is a process of hiding a data and showing a essential information to the user. Abstraction means hiding a data and showing only essential part whichever the user want. This is the concept of abstraction. Then what is abstract method? In abstract method we declare only declaration part, but in abstraction method we are not going to write a full detailed description of the definition. It means abstract method is a method. In that method we are going to declare only declaration part but not a definition part. It means in abstract method we are declare only declaration part. Rest of code are written in a implementation part. It is a abstract method. Then what is abstract class? The class which is contain at least one abstract method is called as abstract class. Abstract class is a class which contains at least one abstract method. And in abstract class, objects are not going to be created. It means in an abstract class, object cannot be created in our Java. And the abstract class include both type of classes. Those are normal methods, abstract methods. It means abstract class includes two types of methods. First one is normal method, which we are already know that writing a normal method in our program. Second one is abstract method. The method which are declared with the abstract keyword is a abstract method. It is called abstract class. Then concrete class. Fourth one is concrete class. Concrete class is a class contains all the implementation in a definition of the program. What is concrete class? Concrete class is a class. It means it is also one type of class which is contain all the implementation of the definition of our program is known as concrete class. In abstraction class, only declaration part will be declared. But in concrete class, all the implementation, it means definition of each and every classes will be implemented. It means concrete class. In a abstraction concept, we discussed abstraction. What is abstraction? What is abstract method? What is abstract class? And concrete class. Two, implementation part is written in a derived class. In a abstract method, implementation part is written in a derived class. It means we have to use a inheritance concept to use a abstraction concept. Now we can discuss with the slides. Here see abstract classes and methods. First one is data abstraction is a process of hiding a certain details and showing only essential information to the users. Data abstraction is a process of hiding a certain detail and showing only essential part to the users. It is nothing but abstraction or a data abstraction. And abstraction can be achieved with either a abstract classes or a interface or a inheritance concept. Abstraction can be achieved with either the abstract classes or the interface concept or the inheritance concept. You already know that inheritance concept, but interface concept we are discussed in the upcoming classes. The abstract keyword is a non-assess modifier used for a classes and methods. The abstract keyword is a non-assess modifier used for classes and methods. It means we have to discuss access modifiers. What are the access modifiers? First one is public, second one is private, third one is protected. These three are the access modifiers used in our Java programming language. But abstract keyword is a non-access modifier used for a classes and methods. This is all overview about data abstraction. Now we can discuss one by one what is abstract class, what is abstract method and concrete class. First one is abstract class. The abstract class is a class, is restricted class that cannot be used to create an object. Before this only I am told that what is that abstract class cannot be created any object and it is not allowed to create any object. Here only that only abstract class is a restricted class that cannot be used to create an object. To access it, it must be inherited from the other class. To achieve this abstract class, we must inherit from the another class. We have to use a inheritance concept to implement the abstract class. A class which is declared as a abstract is known as abstract class. A class which is declared as a abstract is known as abstract class. Before we are going to declare a abstract class, we can use a abstract keyword to declare any class. It can have a abstract and non-abstract method. Abstract class include a both abstract and non-abstract method. Previous only I am told that. What are? In a abstract class, we are going to use a normal methods and a abstract methods. That only. Normal method means non-abstract methods. Abstract method, method nothing but abstract method only. It needs to extend and its method implemented. It cannot be instantiated. It needs to be extended and its method implemented. It cannot be instantiated. It means the abstract class can be extended with other class and also it implemented another method, but it cannot be instantiated. Instantiated means initialization. Example of the abstract class is here is there. With the abstract keyword, we are declaring a class. The class name is A. Abstract class A. This is a opening and closing of the class. With a abstract keyword, we are going to create a class. That class is nothing but abstract class. Second one is abstract method. The abstract method are the methods only declaration part will be declared but not definition or a implementation part. In a abstract method we write only declaration part but we are not going to write a full definition of each methods and an implementation of each part of our program. We cannot write. This is the concept of abstract method. Here, abstract method can only be used in a abstract class and it does not have body. Abstract class is used in a abstract class itself. It does not have any body. The body is provided by the subclass, that is inherited class, or that class can be inherited form. A method which is declared as an abstract and does not have an implementation is known as an abstract method. A method which is declared as an abstract and does not have an implementation is known as an abstract method. It means the abstract method won't include the definition or a implementation part. It includes only declaration of the program. This is the concept of abstract method. Here the example of abstract method is there. The print status method can be declared with the abstract keyword. Because of this, this is an abstract method. Here, way to achieve an abstraction. There are two types of ways are there to abstract, to achieve an abstraction concept in our Java. Those are, first one is abstraction class, second one is interface. With the help of abstraction class also we can achieve the abstraction concept. With the help of interface and inheritance concept also we are going to achieve the abstraction in our Java programming. Here is the one example is there to explain the abstract class that has a abstract method. First, here they are created the bike class with the abstract keyword. Because of that, this is a abstract class. See here. In abstract class, they are created one method, that is void run method, with the abstract keyword. This is called abstract method. And again they are created one more classes, that is Honda 4. That Honda 4 class extends the bike class. It means here we are going to use a inheritance concept. It means we are calling a another class in our class. In Honda class, they are declared void run method. In this, they are printed running safely. Again, they are written main method. In main method, they are created the OBJ object with the help of new keyword. With the abstract class and a normal class name. It means with the help of parent class, we are going to create a child class object. With the help of that object, we are going to call the child class method, that is obj.run. The output is running safely. This is the program of abstraction class and a method. I hope you all are understand this abstraction concept. Here there are some points to remember this abstraction concept. What are all? Now we can See one by one. An abstract class must be declared with an abstract keyword. The abstract class must be declared with an abstract keyword. It can have an abstract and a non-abstract method. Abstract class always contain a normal methods and a abstract methods too. It cannot be instantiated. Instantiated is nothing but a initialization. It cannot be initialized or instantiated. It can have a constructor and a static method also. It can have a final methods which will force the subclass not to change the body of the method. It can have a final method which will not force the subclass that not going to change the body of the method. These are points to remember for the abstraction concept. I hope you all are understand this concept. Thank you.